Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world away. We now got the next part of the Fanhome release of Build the Iron Man Mark III Armour. We're doing stages 11 to 14. Now I know what a lot of you are thinking. You're thinking, wait, why haven't you done this on the channel for so long? Just so you know, basically I got to stage 10. You've probably seen that on the channel, and there is a playlist. I think I've linked the playlist up here actually. And when I got to issue 10, my subscription was reset back to issue 1 again. So I've had to wait 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 before I get this one, which is, makes me perfectly aware that I'm now probably 3 months behind everybody else. So for that reason, going to show you where we're up to. So if you remember the first issue, we did the helmet here, and we've got the lights on it there, on off, looking pretty cool. Then we've done the boot looking like that, which has got a switch on, and once again I can push the button and the light comes on that one there. Lots of moving parts on this. And it does take little cell batteries, so I'm not worried about the batteries leaking or anything. We got the arc reactor that we done once again. Push that on and that turns on and off like that. We did have a problem with the back here not sitting flat. Mine still doesn't. I don't know if that's going to be an issue later, but we'll see that later on. We also did the arm. Now at the moment with the arm and the gauntlet, this is the gauntlet here, just to show you that lights up inside there. It's not meant to be attached to this arm at the moment, but I couldn't help myself, I have to say. So I've put it on now anyway. When we come to do that in the instructions, I will show you what I've done on there. But that's the arm and the gauntlet. I think the problem I've got at the moment, this hand is a little bit loose in there. So I might have to think about what I'm going to do with that. And then the last thing that we ended up doing in the last stages was creating another joint here. And we're going to be basically adding on to this joint in these stages. So if you want to get this for yourself, I've put the link down here to the Fanhome website. You can get this all the way from pack one. But it's been a while, so without further ado, let's get cracking. So as you can see in this stage, we're going to be doing the right shoulder joint. We've got some parts here that we're going to be adding onto the joint that we created last time. We're going to be putting some springs in there, and then we're going to be encasing that with the covers on each side. So at the end, it looks just like that. So as I mentioned last time, we're going to need this part here. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to be screwing these little tiny springs into the holes on this side here and the other side here. Now, we've got some HP screws for that purpose. And we want to screw in the end of the spring, which has got a round circle rather than a hook section. So I'm going to line that up and then screw this in. There we go. And that's one spring on. Just do the same on the other side. So when they're on, you don't want them too tight. You want them to be able to move just like that. But that's the springs in place. We want to then take the frame section, which looks like this. This is metal. And that's just going to fit over this section, probably best on the top camera, just like that. Once that's in, we're just going to be getting the springs we just installed, and we're going to be putting them over the lugs that we've got just on this bracket that we put in. So one this side. Might help to have tweezers just to help you do this. And when that's in, it should look like that. We're going to do the same on the other side. So then that's all the way down, and the spring should fit flat in there on both sides. And once we're happy with that, we're going to be putting on these covers here. They look just like this. They're going to follow the shape of what we've got in here. So basically one's going to go on this side, making sure we line this up. And then push that in. And then we just put one on the other side here. So there we go, we've got this full section looking like that. We've also got this tab here, but we don't actually use that because this is the end of the stage. Stage 12, we're going to be adding a lot more details to the right arm now, so it's actually growing. We're also going to be putting in the ball joint for the shoulder section that we just built in the last stage. So at the end of it, we've got quite a long arm in here. As you can see, they haven't attached the hand yet. That's something that I've already done off my own back. Surprisingly, look at this pack. They've gave us our own screwdriver again. I've got absolutely loads of these kind of screwdrivers now. I won't be using that though. I'm going to use my own one. But the metal plates here are metal, flawless paintwork, and they look just like that. Now the first thing we want to do on this, we've got these adhesive stickers here. I'm going to take them off. They're going to be just put on the arm covers here on both sides of these metal arm sections. So just line them up. These are going to help the arm not get damaged when it's moving and stuff. Just make sure that's perfectly lined up flat on there. Just like that. And you're going to do the same on the other side. So I've got another adhesive sticker here. It's just going to go onto this section on the inside here. When you've got big sections like this, I think tweezers will help you out a lot better to get these lined up perfectly. Now this one doesn't sit as flush as the first one did, but they should look like that when they're in. So we need this armor section looking just like that. And what we're going to do is we're going to mount the arm, which we've just done, into this section here. So having it this way round, it's just going to be fitting into this section here so that the hole that we've got there is going to be going into the hole that we can see there. That's what's going to hold that in. Now that's going to be held in with just one EM screw. So I've got that here. I am going into metal. So especially on this build, I am going to just dip the tip of that in a little bit of 3-in-1 oil. Line it up. And we'll get that screwed all the way in, as hard as you can get it. Now we're going to be attaching the joint that we just made in the last stage. So we want to put this just into the channel like that. Now we're going to hold this into place with the tab that we had last time, which looked like that. That comes from the last stage. Now that's just going to go over these two lugs that you can see there. So if I just balance this on where it goes. So when that's in, that's going to fit just like that. It's going to be held in with EM screws. This will stop that joint falling out. Once again, I have dropped it in a little bit of oil. And here's the second one. Excellent. That's still able to rotate in there just like that. We're then going to close it up by putting the other metal side on here. It's just going to go over the top like that. As you can see, we've got a couple of screw holes just in the top. Once again, they're EM screws. That's the first one in. And there's the second one. So as you can see, we've got quite a bit of articulation in that arm now, including the shoulder joint there. So it gives you an idea of what the full bodywork's going to work like. Brilliant articulation, have to say. With the hand section on there as well, it looks like that. But that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 13, as you can see here, we're still working on the shoulder section now, which is just going to go onto the top of this, a little bit more of the iron plating here. We're also going to put another hinge just on the end of the section that we made at the first part of this pack, and that's all there's going to be to do. So that looks just like this. I'm just going to get out this section here. The arm's metal. This bit of detail is plastic, just so you know. And all we're going to do is the gap in this side of the arm here, we're just going to be pushing this into place. It is just a push to fit. So once it's in, push it in, make sure it fits nice and flush in there, just like that. It clips in, that's going to hold that section in. We're then going to be putting the shoulder support in. Now this is going to be held in with a spring. So basically this is going into this section that you can just see there like that. Now it's all about the slots in here. So with this spring, you've got a little notch just on this side of that hinge. So this is going to fit in like that. The other end of it is going to fit into the notch. Do you remember this on the last stage? Into this bit of the spring here. You see a notch just on the side there? So when this is in, this section here is going to fit into that notch there. So once I've got that on, that is how the spring is going to go in. So the long end onto the notch and the hook end just onto the side of this section here. We've then got this pin here to keep all of that together. So we just get the pin, put it through this side and make sure it goes through the spring. Looks good, we've got it through. There we go, they're all the way through now. So now that's spring loaded. So as you can see, when I do this, It wants to snap back like that. But that, just that little section there, quite a little bit fiddly, is all there is to do in that stage. Which then brings us all the way to the last stage here, stage 14. We're just going to be working on the right shoulder. We're going to get this all into place and made up so that at the end of it, we've pretty much got the full arm and shoulder section complete. They do want us to put the hand at the end of this, but I've already done that. Just so you know, when it comes to this stage, this is really hard to push in there. Don't be surprised if you have some problems, but persevere, it will go in eventually. So to make the shoulder, we've got these two sections here, and basically they're going to be going together. So if you hold it the way I've got it exactly like this here, this section is going to go inside this section here. So it's able to rotate on this axis that you can just see there. Probably best to look at the pictures for this as well. Now we've got these pins here that we're going to be pushing into place to keep these into place. Now they have got a little sort of like keyhole design on them to make sure we push these in the right way. So we just matched it up. These pins are metal, so you can go to town on these and just push them in so that they come out of the other side there. Now they are going to be screwed, and they're going to be screwed with GM screws. So I'm going to put one in this side. This is going into metal, so you might benefit with a little bit of oil on that. And we're just going to do exactly the same on the other side. Match the keyhole pattern up with the inside. Make sure that fits flush in there, like that. Turn it over, GM screw, just into the other side. And put that in nice and tight. So there should be movement in there like that, but it shouldn't be too loose. All we need to do then is just put these caps on, and they're gonna hide the screw holes. These are just a push in like that. So one on that side, one on the other side. I'm making sure that the lines on this are facing the edge of this section here. But now, as you can see, when that moves with it as well. But that's that section done. All we've got to do then is just mount this spring-loaded hinge that we had here into the section inside there, which has got the two lugs. So we make sure this sits comfortably in the hole here. So I've just cut there because I'm just going to pull this back a second. Just got to put the last IP screw in here. I realized I had this middle section the wrong way round. Basically on the arm, this should be the flat side that's pointing towards the arm, and these indents here should be on the bottom section of the shoulder joint here and on the top section of this top one here. My one wasn't like that, and I'm sure you were all screaming at the screen to let me know that was wrong, but you know, I make mistakes, so you don't have to. But the articulation there, as you can see now, is absolutely perfect. But that is the arm complete. If I just put the armor section here just on the hand again, that looks pretty impressive. It's quite weighty as well, and if you want an example of size, quite big. But the articulation is just amazing with the hands there. You've obviously got the shoulder you've just seen me rotating there that moves, the elbows move, it twists. It's absolutely brilliant. But I'm pretty impressed with that, just to say we've done an arm. But that is stages 11 to 14. So I'm going to gently put that down there. And just let you know that hopefully the next one of this will be in 4 weeks' time. You won't have to wait as long. Once again, if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link for the Fanhome website down the bottom there. You can get this all the way from stage one. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.